following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Oh, look who we have. It's a beautiful thing. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We are taken by storm.
Taken by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy camo! I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome all. This is Dave White sitting in for the one and only Tom O'Brien. And we're going to be talking technology this whole segment. Normally we do the second half. Tom's off to Boston, I think. So he'll be back on Monday. But if you've ever wanted to call in on a Friday and talk about some bigger, big picture ideas about technology, this is certainly a good day to do it. You can call me at 877-927-6648, or you can actually email me at path@tfnn.com if you have a question. The first one we had for this segment came from last hour, but it's about both Facebook and IBM. The question is, after this week, do we have anything that really you can hang your hat on in either Facebook or IBM? Of course, if you paid any attention to the snooze, Facebook's CEO was in front of Congress yesterday or day before, yesterday, trying to talk up his cryptocurrency discussion. Really nobody having any of it. They don't like him much. They don't like the idea of cryptocurrencies much and his control over it after a lot of the things that they said and did, which turned out to be untrue. As I like to say, if you watch the House of Commons on Sunday night on C-SPAN, if you're one of the MPs, you get tossed out if you call somebody else a liar. So they have about 1,000 ways to call everybody a liar. And the one I like the best is an economy with the truth. Certainly, nobody really picking up on it, and more people falling out on the Libra stuff. And of course, during the discussion, he basically said how it wasn't about making any money. And then instantly in the next paragraph of his transcript, talked about how it was going to make so much money for Facebook. And I think that was about it. As far as looking at the chart, you have about the same volume down at 173 as you had previously at 176. My guess is that you are going to come back at least back in that and test it one more time. The discussion continues to be in this, whether they split it up or just put a lot of government oversight. Of course, Facebook wants government oversight because any smaller companies wouldn't be able to afford it. They would easily be able to afford it and keep any of these ne'er-do-wells that would want to be in their same business, like Snap, out of that. I think they come out next week for earnings, if I'm not mistaken. This has got a kind of a similar pattern, back down to $12.71. Again, any breakup of Facebook probably would help Snap out. In the long term, right now, I don't see a lot happening in it, but that's it. The next question is about IBM, and some folks saw the articles this week about Google saying that they were at least stating that they did have what's known as quantum superiority. The idea is that if you you could use a classical computer, like everybody's familiar with, the one in your pocket on your desktop, They use bits. Those bits are either a zero or a one. But quantum computers use kind of a deep, dark magic where the bit can either be at the same time a zero and a one, or even, depending on which kind you're looking at, zero to a one with an infinite amount of steps. They don't have that quite yet. The real purpose of this is problems that would be uncalculatable. And probably the easiest example is the one in computerdom that I learned early on. It's called the traveling salesman program. That is, you got 40 cities to go to. What's the, if you check each one and the path to each one and all the permeations of it, you find out it takes like 10,000 years to actually find all those in 40 cities and find out which one's the best one. Of course, we use kind of some shortcuts to do that today. You know, UPS, FedEx, they all have the routes worked out for them. But if they really wanted to make sure that everything was as good as it could get it, it'd take a long time. They've already said that they have broken a couple of these kinds of problems and solved them in 3 to 5 minutes. IBM is saying, no, you haven't. No one really knows, other than you got to assume that there's not a lot in for Google for saying this is true if it is not. There is a lot for IBM, who's bet their entire future on this. Besides having a bad earnings day, of course, this has been hanging over IBM for a while. The question is whether or not IBM can find enough business in quantum computing in the next couple of years to really handle the turnover from their old business of software and consulting to actually get into selling these to the government, which is basically what they're looking at long term. We've talked about how this is probably going to be at least 2 years before they start making money from it. And everybody in Silicon Valley is into quantum computing. Microsoft, Google, Facebook, all those folks have done it. There's a company in Toronto, just outside of Toronto, called D-Wave, who has kind of a way of doing the same kind of thing that has been selling them for a couple of years. On very specific problems, these things work fairly well. And they work on a way that's very close to the way that machine learning works. And that is that you, you try to find out the resting case. That would take a long time to explain. But kind of, if you're going through the mountains, you try to find the lowest place between the peaks. And that's kind of the way that the D-Wave one works. Doesn't give you an exact answer, but gets you kind of close. Then you can use it like a traditional computer to go back and find the exact one. Google's, from what they're saying, does give quantum superiority. That means that the biggest computer in the world that exists today could not outperform the Google's, basically, I think it's 57 qubit computer. Compared to, you know, a massively huge computer. But this 57-qubit computer would outperform any kind of big computer. Ooh, there's some more. There's some audio. Anyway, we'll be back in a minute. Give me a call, 877-927-6648.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN, and you'll find market insights under trading newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
If you're a trader in the market looking for exposure to gold or gold mining equities, then now is a perfect time to sign up for Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. The summer is over, gold is trading back above $1,500, and the 10-year Treasury is hovering at around 1.5%. Tom O'Brien has been writing his weekly gold report for almost 18 years. There's no one that knows more about how the gold market trades and how gold mining equities react. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, Tom publishes his weekly gold report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. As of September 3rd, Gold Report subscribers have 5 active open positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 38% for each position. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up today by visiting TFNN.com.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And we're back. Dave White sitting in for Tom O'Brien. We've got plenty of time left out here today. Give me a call at 877-927-6648 or email me at path@tfnn.com. And what else do we have here? We'll look at a lot of stuff. Okay, got a couple of emails here. Get that. Okay. So, Keys. Keysight Technology, they make a lot of test equipment, oscilloscopes, that kind of stuff. Been wildly successful as 5G is coming into the market. What we've seen here lately, though, is a retest of the September 19th high at 102. That had 11 million shares. The best we got was at this fairly decent high was 3 million shares. We're getting to the point now where in 2020, a lot of 5G technology is going to roll out. And most of the people that are going to be in this business have bought these expensive $100,000, $200,000, $500,000 devices for testing a lot of the high frequency applications of 5G. And not going to be surprised that this thing has led the first round into 5G, but at the same time, not really seeing the kind of love back up here at above $100 and a little reversal. Yesterday's close, today's close put you back into the trading range, and you may get a little lot more consolidation as we go forward in the coming months. Another one of the questions in the markets it was on a company we mentioned when it went public. I never could get a good read on the thing chart-wise, so didn't get in it. But I really liked it when it came out, and that was Avalara. This company is one that I've kind of liked. It came back to its last major breakout, which is May 8th. Did it on 4 million shares. You tapped it the first time with 900,000 shares. The second time with about the same thing. And now you got a little bounce out here. You may get one more move down to 65. If you want a good trade, if the trade deal with China blows up, then this is your company. The reason why these guys handle all these tax and trade and tariff issues on software with a kind of a software as a service for all of that, where you can plug in and they know every different place that you can ship something to in the world and how to take care of those tariffs and can react very quickly. Most of the major 500 S&P 500 companies are using it. Of course, it's kind of coming off as the discussions about trade seem to at least get settled on phase one. If that were to blow up, I think you'd want to be all over this one. Again, it's rise to $93 from the mid-20s after it IPO'd was probably a pretty good indication. I think somewhere in that $60 range is fairly decent and good support. But again, you want to keep an eye on that to see how things are going. But that is one. The other, GRNC, we've talked about before, which is, did I spell it right? Generac. Is that right? GNRC. I did not that. No. GNRC. Generac. This thing has been a rocket ship up. You got kind of a 2 days out here that look like this may be topping if you're unfamiliar with this company. It makes generators, both portable and fixed generators for your house. And of course, this thing, since this gap up when the fires started in California and the talk of shutting off power for infinite amounts of time in California, has a lot of people trying to go to California and install these as quickly as possible. I have one down here in Florida. It's not beyond the scope of reason to be out of power for a handful of days or a week. These will automatically turn on when the power to your house goes off, and you can have big 500,000-gallon tanks of propane that they'll run on for weeks. So not a bad deal. And, of course, you wire it directly into your house, that kind of stuff. They also have the less expensive ones that you just plug into things. Don't know what their mix is right now, but maybe a little toppy out here. And, of course, any discussions or rain cutting down on the fires out there is kind of a big barometer of this. But as states like California don't do controlled burns, this is just more of something that's going to happen. The reason that we didn't have it before isn't some kind of overall conspiracy, other than the fact that a lot of people think humans shouldn't be in the woods in California. And because they're not in there, they're not putting in roads and fire breaks and all the other reasons that maybe the fires haven't been as bad as they've been before. But again, you can't fix stupid, can you? And it certainly looks like that's what it is out in California. For those that haven't figured out, you got to do controlled burns in a very dry climate like that. The wood just keeps building up until there's a giant fire. Anyway, Generac Holdings, GNRC, my go-to stock anytime there's a hurricane or a lot of disaster stuff with power gets knocked out, everybody decides that they want to have one of those. Okay, we're getting ready to go to break here. We're up 13 points on the S&P cash. Let's see what kind of volume we have. I normally use the CBOE consolidated volume that takes all the tapes together. You can always email me at path@tfnn.com. I'll be glad to send you a link to the CBOE consolidated market volumes. But in the previous times where we've been up at these levels above 3,000, it has been very common to see overall in the markets, maybe 10 billion shares to 12 billion shares. Right now, we're doing about 4.5 billion shares. Now, maybe that volume comes in after the Fed on Wednesday, but just generally when you're doing this light of volume, it tells you one thing, and that the market is built on sand. If you get a storm, you're going to get knocked down. You don't know exactly when everything's going to happen, but you do know things are strong when things are weak. Right now, three little pigs would not say you've got a brick house. We'll be back in a minute.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune into TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And we've got a question from John, who's asking me, if we were trying to get a new laptop, what would you probably look at right now? I'd say that the state-of-the-art laptop for Windows is certainly the Surface Laptop 3 from Microsoft. In this, you've got maybe the most repairable laptop ever made. This one was designed from the get-go to be able to be serviced and repaired almost instantly. And I have to say that when most people are making either their phones or their laptops or the tablets infinitely unrepairable, this one certainly can be upgraded and changed and fixed in short order. And Microsoft been making the best PCs of anybody, including all the third-party people that make Windows PCs. It's kind of hard to beat them right now. They are doing very well. And, of course, Apple had this guy that was kind of the design engineer guru around them for a long time. And his name's Panos Panay. Panay, I think it is. We've got Max from Houston. How you doing today, Max?
I'm doing just fine, David. And I appreciate you having 2 hours straight. My question is about, I'm looking at the SMHs versus the VIX. So I see the VIX taking a dive under 13. Mm-hmm. And I see potentially the SMH having, and when I look at a candle chart, having two gaps.
You've got a whole bunch more, actually, but go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, like the last few days, two gaps. So mm-hmm. VIX being below 13, doesn't that kind of like validate that maybe we have some more to go on the SMHs, perhaps?
No. Well, let me put it this way. Mathematically, if you want to buy puts, the two best things you can have are a VIX below 14 and an implied volatility below 30 in puts. So mathematically, you're actually fairly good. The other thing out here is that you had two previous highs in this range at about 7 million shares. Right now, we're doing about 3.7.
Yeah, I know, which is
million
the volume
shares.
Is dried up. But it seems like at 2 p.m. every day, 2 p.m. my time, which is like 3 your time, it's mm-hmm. like somebody comes in and jacks everything up.
It's not uncommon, especially when you get to highs like this. A lot of times people will dive in short early in the morning, only to get squeezed out by the afternoon. The one thing that I really learned from trading with Tim Ward over a number of years in the mid-2000s from, I think we did a lot from about 2004 to about 2008. And then a lot of the stuff that I was doing just didn't work anymore when the housing market cracked. But the stuff that I really learned up there was that a high volume high is not a high until it gets retested by either more or less volume. In this case, you're up here, and normally what'll happen within 2 or 3 days is you'll pull back into the trading range. So you got 2 more days to get volume. I don't think you can get volume Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday. And generally, the odds are fairly good that that pulls back in below that 123.56 high. So generally, low volatility is a sign not of really healthy markets, but of just generally low belief that markets are going to move very far.
Okay, because I was taking the VIX going lower as being a sign of less volatility, but
it's generally just the opposite. When everybody quits shorting, generally the market's in a high. When everybody's shorting, market's generally at a low. When you see huge numbers, that's almost always the counterfactual on it. Just do the opposite of what most people do. And that's generally where the big money is. The problem is that in the short term, it's easy to be kind of wrong.
But I understand.
In the longer term, do you really worry about this? And if I had to say that there was one thing that Tim Ward taught me was, this is not a breakout unless you have if you have some kind of sign of strength that goes with it.
Yeah.
And I don't see that sign of strength today. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, you're probably not going to get any kind of volume either. So maybe it goes higher, and maybe you're wrong, but you don't know what is going to happen. You only know what's most probable, and most probable at this point is light volume breaks without any kind of follow-on with a volume in the next couple of days almost always pulls you right back down into a trading range or back into the trading range.
Well, excellent. Well, thank you for the explanation.
Okay.
And, appreciate you having for the 2 hours.
I'll
keep listening. Thank you.
You bet. And, of course, anybody else can give me a call at 877 927 6648. Okay. World of Tanks has a new series. Okay. Isn't it spam? I guess I'm getting less spam than I got before. Again, volume pretty much, I'm going to say right after afternoon, just even and maybe even 2 o'clock, or excuse me, 12 o'clock, really nodded off. We're doing about 4.7 billion shares with about 30 minutes left to go. So that probably puts you in about 6.2 billion shares for the CBOE total market volume. That's every share traded no matter where on a public companies. So you get kind of a bigger view. They do split it out between tape A and B, which is the NYSE and the American Stock Exchange, and then tape C, which is the NASDAQ. And of course, they put it up with a notional value from volume. As I said before, we were doing, you know, $500 billion a day previously. We're doing about half that as we get back up into these previous highs above 3,000 on the S&P cash. Now, maybe the Fed decides to go and decide that, you know, negative interest rates are the way. But my guess is that, especially with the five dissenters from last time, that what we're going to get probably is one and done. And my guess is that the market will not like that Wednesday. But maybe things will change. But at least that's what I would hedge on going into Wednesday, not knowing what a handful of people will do in a cloaked room. I'm generally better at seeing what a lot of people do. And, of course, as I'm trying to remember the guy who said it. I will think about it probably over the break. But he says, I generally make a lot of money trading against the mistakes that many people make. I'll try to find that during the break, but that's about it. Anyway, volume very light after about 11, 12 o'clock, kind of cut off. There's not a whole lot going on out after that. Was thinking that maybe we'd have a big pullback today and a blow-off top. Not quite getting that yet today. We're up 13 points on the S&P cash, up 55 on the NASDAQ. Dow's up 172, Russell up 11. Volume light.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Directions Daily S&P Biotech 3x Bull and Bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
And Dave White sitting in for the one and only Tom O'Brien. And normally do our tech segment here. Got a lot of questions coming. One is, where do you go to buy stuff? And the question is, do I still think Newegg is probably the best place to go to pick up something like a Surface laptop? Certainly in Florida, where I don't haven't bought anything lately, but from them. But they didn't charge sales tax to Florida before. They may now. I don't know. But certainly, if you're looking for online retailers, yeah, they're very good. One of the other places I love to look at before I buy anything is certainly a website called slickdeals.net. As I said earlier in the show, I bought some, I think during my show, I was talking about buying some USB 3.0 memory sticks. And this one, if you're really looking for deals, especially going into Christmas, pretty good, especially if you're looking for TVs or credit stuff. They have sponsored deals, which generally are not that good. And then you'll have the actual deals that other people actually put up on the website. And those are generally the ones you want to look at. They don't last long, I ended up buying, I think, 5 USB sticks that were normally $20 for $10 a piece. So I got like $50 for a bunch of memory sticks. But generally, if you need anything on your computer or you need a monitor, if you're looking for good prices, that slickdeals.net, not .com, but .net, is a good place to take a look for our deals, especially for things going on into this Christmas season. Always a great place to take a look at that kind of stuff, too. So, Newegg, that kind of stuff. Question coming in from Ron about IYT. You're back up to this gap lower that goes back to September 16th. On that gap, you spiked it with about 660,000 shares on September 13th. You're up today on about 94,000 shares. So again, market's pushing back up higher. For the last 4 or 5 days, the volumes turned to mush, but slowly moved higher. And generally, that's an indication that you've got shorts that are getting squeezed out at highs. Not that everybody's dying to get into a particular outfit. But anyway, really, we're talking about the last time this thing had any real volume was the 11th. And we're now here almost to the end of the month. And, of course, you get a couple of days, but it's probably going to be light. And then you get into the very end of next week and you get into a little bit of fund buying. So we'll see the kind of the window for a drop probably is mostly based on whether or not they say anything bad on Wednesday. But we will take a look. Question on some of the other stocks that we talked about before last year when we really liked some of the IPOs that were coming to market. Question from Sam comes in on DocuSign. If you're unfamiliar with this company, they had a very good earnings call, and where this thing gapped up on the 6th of, what was that? 6th of September, yeah. DocuSign is a system that records a lot about your computer and you and the clicks and everything else to prove that you signed something online. And I just went into my local bank, I don't know, I'm going to say 2-3 weeks ago, and changed the kind of bank account I had. And guess what? DocuSign is what they use for their back end to validate what you signed. Of course, many new things like even buying a house, other kind of documents like that are in it. But it continues to move up. Now, it's had kind of a decent ride that took it to 59.62 back on March 15th, back down to the low at 43.11 on August 14th, and nice move back up higher. Now, again, I would love this to come back down to about $55 on light volume, and maybe there would be a buy there. Okay, let's go ahead and check the rest of the emails as we go in here. Okay, NVIDIA, NVDA, up a little bit higher today. I'm thinking that this is basically has filled the gap and did so without the kind of volume down. It came down on 49 million shares back on November 16th of 2018. We're filling that today with about 9 million shares. One of the things that's kind of amazed me is that both AMD, NVIDIA, and Intel have gone on probably the last 4 weeks of some rather major price cuts and competition. NVIDIA has dropped the price the last 2 or 3 weeks very significantly on their video cards. And my thought has been that the margins are really going to start to hurt on those video cards from both AMD and NVIDIA. Maybe when we get to the next earnings call, we'll actually see that in NVIDIA. I don't think a lot of people pay attention to it like I do, but if you go on those sites like slickdeals.net, you'll see a lot of those price changes, and that tells you what those folks are actually doing out there. But Intel cut their prices. AMD couldn't stand it any longer, raised their prices. NVIDIA was having $200-$300 off some of the more expensive $800 and $1,000 cards they had. I'm not thinking that this bodes well for NVIDIA. And of course, the big elephant in the room is Intel getting involved in the video card business in a big way in the first quarter of 2020. These companies, again, depend on a lot of memory. NVIDIA buys a lot of its memory from Micron, so does AMD. Intel will make their own memory and theoretically have a kind of a vertical market in the video card business. And, of course, Intel, like I said earlier in the show, biggest memory manufacturer times four of any of the others. It's just that Micron makes a lot of money making VRAM for these video cards. Intel looks to me like it's going to get in and kind of cut a great deal of what NVIDIA and AMD were making in that margins. I don't know how effective their first cards are going to be since there's a lot of work to be done on the software side, but I know that they've been working on this for about 2 years. So when you look at NVIDIA and AMD, know that their video card business is going to be invaded by the big one, Intel inside, not that far away. So and maybe short-term, long-term, problematic, I suspect. Yeah, I just think that the market's kind of doing what it does when it tops out, which is it tends to move and kind of have a blow-off top with a lot. We'll know Monday or Tuesday, so we shall see. I don't think there's a lot left in the tank. I would be the first one to yell and scream and say we're going to the moon if we'd gone up and filled these gaps with volume today, or if we fill them Monday with volume. But we have no volume. We're going to pull back right back into the trading range as we've done so many times before. We'll be back. You still got a little bit of time. Give me a call at 877-927-6648.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And this is Dave White sitting in for Tom O'Brien, wrapping up the day today. And of course, probably the big news is Amazon out here. Was down fairly significantly, and if you dig deep into what it's what they were talking about and the reason why it was down $100 last night, the web services business is slowing. We've heard that from Google and Microsoft, not so much from CRM, but I don't think they've had their earnings out yet. I'll have to check that over the weekend. Anyway, that's why it was down fairly quick. We had a quick Jim Cramer to say, buy anything because it's all about Christmas, when you basically find out that most of the profit in Amazon isn't their business for shipping things to end users. And that's pretty low margin stuff. It's high volume, but low margin. The high margin stuff is all that Amazon Web Services, and that's the part that's slowing down. So we sold off this morning. Everybody changed the argument into, well, we're going to have a good Christmas, so that'll be good for Amazon. But again, maybe we do the same amount of business, maybe the same revenues. Maybe things are good for them for Christmas. But remember that most of the stuff they sell for Christmas is about 5% margin. You put a $10,000 server in there, and you start charging $10 an hour for it, you can get the thing paid off, you know, in about 3 months, and everything beyond then is gravy. And that's why that web services business is so good, is that you take highly expensive stuff, you share it with everybody, you make sure you put it out there on a service, people can spin up stuff and have 100 computers, servers ready to go for anything that you're going to put an ad on tonight's TV show, and you're ready to go. Well, that's a very lucrative business. What's not so lucrative? Dragging stuff to people's houses. Again, 5%, 10% margins maybe, if you're lucky. The big stuff is where Amazon's slowing down and might drop today. High volume says that you retest today's low again before you're ready to go higher. In the meantime, sell when you can, not when you have to. You'll see me here, 2 o'clock, Monday.